Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. I'm the RPG Chick. We're here in the staff room with Headmaster Block, another lovely personage. He's given us two tasks to do. We have to find the library, which the entire thing disappeared, and we have to clean up the utter wreckage in this place somehow. Let's look at the display case and look at this stuff before we leave and try to figure out that our tasks, how to achieve them.
Case documenting the achievements of pupils in the school. Some sports trophies, pictures of slain dragons, pupils in front of smoldering pots. The private place seems to go to a trophy won in a broomball tournament.
One thing about the voice, it seems to get louder and a little louder and softer. It's pretty low right now. But unfortunately the volume only goes from 20%. And then up to 40, and 40 is just too loud, unfortunately.
Broom ball originally went by a different name. It was played on broomsticks using six-winged balls.
Sounds familiar.
That's why today resembles nothing more than soccer, except that each player has a broom strapped to the back. The display case can't be opened like that. It's locked.
Bellows.
A nice pair of bellows. I really get a fire going. When my family wanted to forge something at home, I was in charge of the bellows. You are the most important gnome in this matter, they often used to say to me.
Let's take them then. Oh, right. Right, we... out of Allardyce's file, we pulled this thing out. Let's look at the bellows first.
Bellows. I won't go into details now, but when one pulls the handles apart, they fill with air. Pressing the handles together forces the air out of the tip. Took me a while to figure that out, but I've got the hang of it now.
It's pretty much all the details we'll ever need.
A fire maker is an amazing piece of engineering. You fill it with flammable gas, which is then ignited using complicated technology. A fire maker is an amazing... You fill it with...
Okay. Diagram?
It says, Fireplace Travel Network Map. It shows a lot of fat black dots connected by lines. Above each of the dots is a name. Seastone, Mage Tower, Entrance Hall, Coaching Inn, Fox's Den, and many more. Three animal symbols are located beneath each of the dots. I've heard about this. Wizards use a powder to travel through the fire in one fireplace to the fire in another.
Right.
Of course, this doesn't just work with any fireplace. It must be on the fireplace travel network. And this plan shows which fireplaces are connected to which.
All we need is some flue powder.
One of the dots is circled in black ink. Seastone, Mage School, Staff Room, that's this fireplace.
Right.
A few lines lead away from the... Oh, there seems to be two other fireplaces here in the building itself.
Oh, maybe one goes to the library.
Seastone, Mage School, Astronomicon, and... Hey! Seastone, Mage School, Library!
There you go.
If this fireplace is connected to the library fireplace, we might be able to use it to get in there.
Mm-hmm.
The fireplace here in the staff room is connected to the fireplace in the missing library. The library is represented by the symbols Owl, Worm, and Rat. I need fire, fireplace travel powder, and a little luck. This could be my way into the library.
Sweet.
The fireplace here in the staff... I need... Together with some fireplace travel powder...
Blue powder.
This fireplace could be my ticket to the library. Together with...
Firewood.
A neat pile of firewood. More than enough to make a decent fire.
Put in the fireplace.
It's really cold in here. I'm gonna light a small fire, okay?
Do you intend to burn school property?
No, there's some firewood right here.
Yes, and it belongs to the school.
What do you think it's for, you ignoramus?
Sure.
Just put it in there.
Together with some fireplace trap. Headmaster Block would rather freeze than burn school property. I think he's getting a little carried away myself.
No kidding. Let's look at the clock.
This must be the best clock in the world. Most only have two or three hands. This one has at least 10. I don't really know what the clock wants to tell me, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't just show the time. There's so much to discover. I wish I could stay here forever.
Maybe it's the alignment of all the planets or something like that. Well, the only thing I see here is the paper swan. Oh, we got some origami going on over here.
Oh, how pretty. A swan folded from a piece of paper. This is origami, an ancient elf art form.
It's an elf art form, huh?
The dwarven word for this art form means something like pointy ears build dust catchers out of paper because they can't deal with stone.
Right.
Hey, this isn't just some sheet of paper, it's... Sorry, Swan. It is! Another book page. I'll take it with me.
Oh.
Still missing a few pages, but if I'm lucky, I'll find them all. I can save a book.
Nothing else to look at? Okay. Let's go. Oh! Great.
Whoa! The new caretaker troll.
Great. Hello? Growl?
Hello! Hello? I'm Wilbur Weathervane. Professor Wilbur Weathervane.
I'm gonna eat the map.
I teach, so I'm pleased to make your acquaintance. If you were to talk to me, we could work together to accomplish much more for the school. Come on. I demand that you talk to me.
Right. Someone else to make demands around here.
Looks like you have a lot to do.
What are you doing?
What does it look like?
It looks like you're not doing a lot.
Well, it looks like you're not doing much.
You want to tell me how to do my job?
Yeah, ask me a question.
What is your job?
Look, it's your gun. Yeah, that's your gun. Right?
Have you been a caretaker for long?
You've been a caretaker for long? What exactly are your duties?
I run the place.
Oh.
Nothing here works without me. Just no one notices, that's all.
I see. But don't the teachers and the school administration, etc., have a small share in the success of the school, right?
What success? You've had a look round this dump. It's disgusting. All dirty and run down.
But isn't it your job to keep things clean around here?
Yes, it's quite dirty here, in fact. But isn't it your job to do something about it?
What do you think I'm doing?
Nothing.
Could take a while until you're done cleaning up the mess, right?
If you say so, Mr. Know-it-all.
Huh. The council leader hired you, right?
I bet Council Leader Van Buren got you the job here.
Of course. She wanted the best.
Oh, great. I think she'd be perfectly happy if no progress was ever made here at the school.
Know what your problem is? You're a windbag.
Thanks.
Bert thinks so too.
Who's that?
Bert.
Buddy of mine. He thinks you're a windbag too.
All right.
But I don't even know Bert. Even we just met.
So you're saying I'm lying? That's exactly what Bert, me, and the others hate about you.
What others?
There is no Bert.
You really live in your own little world, you windbag.
It looks like we two have to get the school back in shape.
Headmaster Block has ordered you and I to clean the hall and free it of cobwebs.
Already on it?
Yeah, but it doesn't seem to be progressing.
Oh, you can of course do it better.
Not that, only maybe you could use some help. Do you have any other cleaning supplies? A broom, dustpan?
Sure, got it all. but I ain't giving you none. Get your own.
Yeah.
What's your problem? I'm offering you help and saving you a lot of work.
Oh, boo-hoo, come on.
But if we work together, we'll both be done sooner.
Look, you were told to clean the entrance hall. I was told to clean the entrance hall. If we work together, it will be faster for both of us. Don't you get it?
Sure, Professor Brain should know. The rest of us are idiots.
I never said that, but it is a fact.
Don't know about anything, but want to play the big man here, huh?
It is quite obvious that.
No one else is allowed an opinion. We had that here before, you know. Rotten fascist.
I don't want to fight with you.
Your parents are siblings. Yeah, all three of them.
What? Headmaster Block said you were to give me some cleaning supplies.
Headmaster Block has ordered you to give me some of the cleaning supplies.
Right.
So, you're doing it?
Of course.
Then give them to me.
Oh, sure.
You're making fun of me, right?
No.
No matter what I do, you're not going to give me anything to use to tidy up, right?
Of course I will.
I'm going to get a broom myself.
I could really use some help. Please?
Come on, seriously. I could really use your help. Please.
Can't cope with your life, huh? And now you want me to fix it for you. Just like always.
Like always?
You've never helped me.
Yeah.
We don't even know each other.
Oh. How a fine gentleman considers himself something better now and suddenly doesn't know us anymore.
I never knew you.
I'm slowly beginning to believe you actually find it funny to wind me up.
Everyone hates me because I'm so cool.
I'm sure they don't.
Yes, they do. People say that I'm arrogant. But how should they know? I wouldn't give them time of day. And you know what beats everything?
No?
A hammer. Idiot.
Please let me know if anything unusual happens.
I'm keeping an eye open for a friend, so please let me know if anything unusual happens in the school.
I'm sure he will.
Well, you know, if, for example, someone's wandering around the school who has no business here, or if things disappear, or, you know, things like that.
There was a penny stuck in the door.
You what?
There was a penny stuck in the door, wouldn't it?
Ah, that's probably not important.
Did you put the penny in there?
Me? No.
If I find a coin in there, I'm taking you down.
It was nice talking to you. I really don't understand why so many people don't want to talk to trolls.
Arseholes, the lot of them. They don't want us to speak our minds.
And I think that's wrong. That's why I let you.
Yeah, but then you run down everything I say. Who made you sheriff here? This school is going downhill and has been for a long time. Ever since you and a few others came here, there's been nothing but stress.
Hang on a minute. Isn't this your first day?
Didn't used to be that way. But now everything has to be politically correct, or you get silenced immediately.
Yeah, well goodbye.
You know, the sad thing is, I've worked with people who acted that way, no matter what you said, make a difference.
Oh, hello.
Why have you always got to be in my face?
It's fun. We need to somehow get rid of the kobolds.
Headmaster Block wants to get rid of the kobolds.
Didn't tell me.
But he did tell me, and I want you to help me.
Want whatever you want.
Why are you always like that?
Why are you like that?
Like what?
Like
so
like
unfriendly,
yourself.
Destructive, and such an ass.
Trolls troll.
Right. There's no way you can catch the kobold.
I know why you don't want to help. You can't. You're neither smart enough nor fast enough to catch the kobold.
I can do anything better than you can, that's for sure.
Prove it.
But I don't have to prove anything to you.
Yeah, you do. That's okay. I like the kobolds.
Never mind. I like the kobolds. To be honest, I'm actually even proud of them.
Yeah, I've seen better.
Yeah, however, it would make me really angry if someone scared the kobolds off.
Huh? You talking to me?
Things can't go on like this. Is that all you want? Just to be a right pain in the ass all your life? Someone who just annoys others without ever lifting a finger?
Blah, 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 blah. What is it? Finally notice your own stupidity?
What a sweetie.
Want to apologize? Ha, loser.
That was a waste.
No kidding. One more time just to see if there's any new options.
Don't have anything to talk to him about, so that's good. How can I ever get the hall cleaned up? And by 72 o'clock?
When the hell is 72 o'clock?
Wow, this isn't dust and dirt. It's even though no one... No idea how to reach him up there. Well, it's not just that he's very far away, he just never stops flying around.
Let's open the windows and talk to a troll, I guess. Yeah, open these windows. Cobwebs.
Those are the cobwebs the headmaster wants me to get rid of. Not only are there a lot of them, they're much too high for me. How am I supposed to get up there to remove the cobwebs? I'm not good with heights. Like most gnomes, I get nervous when the soil is further than one gnome away.
One gnome away. They use themselves as measurements. Here. Automation spell on the troll.
Can I use it to make him work faster? Probably. But I don't think I should do it. Using magic to compel living creatures to do something against their will. Ugh. I didn't become a mage to do things like that.
That stinks. Anything that'll help us reach this? Dry boards. Enchant the cobwebs?
Nothing. Probably hit a hole. Nothing.
Shoot the kobold down? Doesn't want to do it, I bet.
I don't think I'd hit him. I'm not a very good shot with a magic wand.
Okay, or he doesn't think he could do it. What else we got? What if we pay him? No. My phone is about to die. That's... I'm using that to time myself, so I plugged it in. We can only look at the front door. We can't leave now.
The door to the magic school actually consists of several doors. One for the large creatures, such as trolls. One for humans and elves and the like. And then there's one for gnomes and dwarves, and one for even smaller beings. That is supposed to symbolize that everyone is welcome in the school. But in reality, graduate mages are almost exclusively human. I'm the first non-human to graduate in many years. Guess that's why my door hinges squeak.
Huh.
I can't leave until I've completed the three tasks and informed the headmaster. I don't want to let the archmage down.
Wait, two tasks? When do we get a third?
I can't leave until... I don't want to let the arch...
Alright, let's get back into the classroom then. Whoa.
This is the desk that Chantal... Hard to imagine too. Timmy, though. Well...
Now he's sitting on that book.
Oi! Stop that! He kissed the picture of the princess. Probably better if I put the book in a safe place.
Alright, we've got the book now. I wanted to take it in the first place. Tacky book of fairy tales?
I saved the book of fairy tales from that annoying kobold. But maybe I can use the book to lure him into a trap.
Really now. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. I want to hit escape out of the thing. The, freaking, what do you call it? Inventory.
He was crazy about the Book of Fairy Tales. Well, rather, the picture of the princess is in it. That's just not right.
Well, princesses are generally pretty.
He was crazy. That's...
What does the open spell... Oh, I'm sorry, guys. What does the open spell do again? It opens all kinds of things. Oh. Do we need to open something? I wonder if we can open the apparatus, perhaps. Oh! We can get in a cabinet with that spell.
I need fire. Maybe the old fire maker could help. Nothing. Either it's broken or missing fuel, or I'm not using it correctly. I would have to learn more about it. A fire maker? You fill it with...
There's nothing to interact with in here. Alright, let's go. Where's that kobold? Oh, he's back over here.
He was crazy about the Book of Hats.
That's not right. Okay. Staff room. Yeah, I can use the open spell on this. Put the lock on. I want to take the lock off.
Work. The spell opens loops, straps, hooks, and eyes. Things like that. I could try. as I suspected. There's another spell to open locks.
Huh. Maybe I can talk to him about the troll not cooperating. I'm sure he won't be helpful, though.
Excuse me, Headmaster Block.
Yes?
I met the troll caretaker.
I met the caretaker? Troll?
I know what you want to say. I'm not enthusiastic about it myself. Trolls are sullen, slow, and rude.
No kidding.
But what can I do? They have a stranglehold on the janitorial market. We must live with it. Still, we were able to negotiate a good contract.
What do you mean?
Paragraph 1, Section 1. The troll is not allowed to speak with any school employee or student unless explicitly requested.
Okay.
So, I'll get back to work then.
Be my guest.
Won't help with no fire burning.
Use the dry boards instead.
I hope that is not school property that you intend to burn there, Professor Weathervane.
Absolutely not. No?
No. Well,
is it school property or not?
Just lie.
I hope that is not school proper.
They're just a few old boards, the old bag.
They're just a few old boards.
From the school here?
Yes, but you should have thrown them away.
You should have thrown them away, but you didn't do so.
I'm doing so now. Better to burn them than throw them away.
I thought to myself, why throw away the boards and waste expensive firewood? Why unnecessarily burden school finances?
Good thinking, Professor Weathervane. Carry on.
Exactly.
Wowzers! Even outside the classroom, this job is more complicated than I first thought.
Now we can actually put them in there.
That's a good start. However, I can't light the wood directly. I mean, it's dry, but not dry enough to burn easily.
I know this isn't gonna work. We need to light them on fire. Conjure up a fire.
I don't know how to conjure fire. Might have been part of my mage training, but I never learned.
Automation? No. Put the plans in the fireplace?
Better not. That sheet won't have been in Allardyce's file for nothing.
Okay, so what do we do now to start a fire? Got a light? What are you doing there? Where are you going?
He was crazy about that.
Yeah. Huh. Well, not sure. Any more hint about this thing?
I don't know how the machine works. I need to learn more.
Well, I have the diagram.
I could sew the pages into a choir later.
Okay. I have to think on this, on what to do next. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.